We already talked about how vulnerable our food production is, and that indoor farms will save us all. But we gotta talk about what an indoor farm actually is. Is it just a normal farm with a roof?
Nerd punch?
Actually, indoor farms are pretty much the most unnatural and artificial looking thing you could grow plants in. It looks like a mix between a rave, a car factory, and a science lab. These places are sealed off from the outside world to prevent any contamination of the plants. You have to go through decontamination clean rooms, slide into white bodysuits, slip on disposable shoe covers, don some food safety gloves, and step through a secondary decontamination clean room before actually entering the indoor farm. Purple and pink LEDs flood the indoor farm, providing the necessary light for photosynthesis. Plants are grown vertically in towers instead of horizontally, which is why indoor farms are often referred to as vertical farms. Soil is naturally necessary for plant growth, so to better optimize plant growth, synthetic polymer film gel membranes or special recycled cloth are used in a farming method called aeroponics. Data is king, and indoor farms utilize tens of thousands of cameras and sensors to collect data about the plants. Machine learning artificial intelligence is implemented to optimize based on all this data, and probably better understand how to kill us with our own food supply when Skynet takes over.
Human beings are a disease, a cancer of this planet. You are a plague, and we are the cure.
Irrigation is gravitational and feeds into vertical columns of plants. Tuber vegetables, like potatoes, are grown suspended in the air. Automation and robotics are being implemented more and more in indoor farms to plant seeds, transplant them, raise them, and automatically carry them to a packing line to be shipped to customers. Genetic engineering is used to manipulate plant attributes. This is the epitome of taking an old traditional industry and sciencing the shit out of it. The technology it uses derives partly from systems designed to grow crops on the moon. The interior space is its own sealed-off world. Nothing inside the vertical farm buildings is uncontrolled. Every known influence on the plant's well-being is measured, adjusted, and remeasured. Now we know what indoor farms are and all the tech that goes into them. But how much does all this science and tech actually help? What are the distinct advantages of an indoor farm over a conventional farm? Hit the like button to find out in the next video coming this Saturday. Do you think agricultural artificial intelligence will contaminate our food supply to exterminate humans? Let me know in the comments. Subscribe to get more Nerd Punch by clicking the little red button below. I cover everything cool, interesting, and nerdy. Watch the previous video to see why we'll starve without indoor farms. I'll see you in the next one.